The road to the games is going to be a long and interesting and very exciting journey. It's going to be full of challenges, ups and downs, and we tell the athletes from now, your training and everything that we're going to do leading up to the games has to be more difficult and more challenging than the games itself. Your training needs to be harder than the games. That's the most important thing. Ultimately, the performance of the athletes is not in my full control. I can do my job to ensure that they are trying to get ready and do everything that they can to get ready for a competition. But as an athlete, when I was competing, I had a lot more control over that, over the outcome of the result. As a coach, I can only be responsible for certain elements. And I do my best to ensure that the athletes are doing everything in their power to cover every aspect of their training. So that is the most challenging part for me, is ultimately that it's up to the athletes. I was on the national team for 12 years. I was a 6-time Pan American champion, a 2-time world medalist. I retired in 2008 after the World Championships, after my second silver medal. And even during that time, I was coaching. I had a couple of athletes who were on the national team as well, even back then. And that's it. So since my retirement, I've been focusing a lot more on coaching. Kumite is combat. There are certain rules that the athletes need to follow. I guess you can call it controlled contact to the face, relatively good contact to the body. Kumite is a combination of kicks, punches, sweeps, some throws. So it's actually quite exciting for a spectator to watch, just because it's a very, very fast-paced sport. The athletes need to really push themselves past what their physical limits are, to really go above and beyond what they're used to. Just because for me as a coach, it's very important that we get the most number of medals at the games. We have 10 athletes. I want 10 medals.